quicker. Would you agree with that?
Certainly, Hazel. I mean, to be honest with you, I think our British gymnasts, they've always had the difficulty, they've always had the execution, but the one thing that really haven't had on the world stage is confidence and belief that they can actually compete on this world stage. And suddenly, you know, they come out here with all of this support, and it is just incredible. As soon as the gymnasts salute, this place just erupts, and suddenly there's that extra belief there, and they're just walking up, and they're just absolutely nailing every single routine. And here we are now with three medals on the medal tables, and obviously everybody's there thinking, yes, we can do well in sailing, we can do well in rowing, but here we are now on top of the world in gymnastics.
And the one that Beth Werther clearly wants is Olympic gold. She'd love a medal of any colour, I suspect, Matt, because it's the only thing that's not in her collection. Judging by her performance in qualification and indeed right through the team competition, how do you assess her chances this afternoon for us?
Well, I mean, she can go into this with confidence. Nobody's actually scored higher than her, even including the all-around and team competitions as well. So when she set that mark, I mean, it's a really high benchmark to go for. But there are some incredible gymnasts in this final, and there's one Chinese girl that we believe is going to go for a 7-3 difficulty. We think Beth's going to be in and around at the 7, but just to think that a step to the side was what cost her a medal in Beijing. I mean, I'm with you, Hazel. I just wanted to get a medal because you know what? She so deserves it. What she has done for British gymnastics is just incredible. I mean, she's kind of been like the Captain Cook, if you like, just ploughing that path, going off into unknown territory, and suddenly all of our British gymnasts just follow on behind her. I mean, she is just truly remarkable, and you know, it would be a fairy tale ending to what has been an incredible career.
I agree with you, Matt. And you know, one of the most important points here is, as you say, she's been a standard bearer for British gymnastics, and that is so important in what is still a subjective judging system in gymnastics, that you see athletes who are established and are therefore able to show the rest of the team the way. Do you get the feeling that basically Great Britain's gymnasts have earned their stripes in a judging sense over the last few years as a consequence of her?
Oh, no doubt about it. No doubt about it. People walk out and they go, hang on a minute, here comes Beth Tweddle. Let's stop judging for a second and let's just have a look at the incredible difficulty that she can come up with. And she has this kind of, this dynamic force behind her routines, which is just mesmerizing to watch. And you know, she earns every single medal that she's won. But to be honest with you, when you look at it, you can think of all the world and European titles that she's won, but she's done so much more for gymnastics, like I said, than going out there and winning these medals. And I think everybody wants to see her get that. Can we say gold? I don't know. Just get a medal, you know. It's kind of it's her and Kath Granger, really, I think, coming into these Olympics that everybody wants to see get a gold. And we're just hoping that she can just go through a routine and just get to the end and hopefully not step to the side on a dismount and just get a medal that she so deserves.
Yeah, well, Kath Granger did it, as you say, Matt. We'll be back to you in about, 55 minutes time. So enjoy it. And I'm sure the atmosphere is building beautifully down there. It sounds like it. So enjoy for now and we'll catch you very shortly. But Greenwich.
Yes, and I'm not on the rings at the moment, but the gymnasts will be out in just a while. Now, before that, I've got Imogen Cairns and Jennifer Pinchers here, who did an incredible job in the women's team final. Girls, it's lovely to see you. How was it down there performing in this incredible arena?
Absolutely amazing. I mean, the crowd, I have never competed in a home crowd.
Yes.
And I mean, I used the crowd to help me as well, so the roar behind there was incredible.
This is the thing, we were just having a little word earlier on with Hazel about how, you know, British gymnastics, you've got the moves, you've got the execution, you just need that extra little push and the feeling of support to be able to perform. And Jenny, I mean, after Beam, you went out there and you rocked this place.
Thank you very much. Like, obviously I had that slip up on beam at the start, but the crowd were all behind me, so I wanted to come back stronger and prove that I could perform on the floor and the vault.
Yeah.
And hopefully I managed to do that. I got personal best scores. So.
Just, yeah, exactly. Performing out of your skin. Now, Beth's obviously up in a short while. What are you feeling at the moment? Just quite all right about this?
We've just seen her.
Yeah.
She's really chilled out. She's really happy, which is good. You know, there is nothing more this girl can do. You know, she has gained everything. This will be the cherry on the top. But she knows this routine day in, day out, you know? She just deserves this. Fingers crossed.
We're all behind her, and we'll talk more about her routine as the final gets closer. But beforehand, I found Jerry and Anne, Beth's mum and dad. Now, you've followed her all over the world.
We have.
Did you think that after Beijing that you would be standing here now, 4 years later, about to watch her go again and hopefully, fingers crossed, get a medal?
immediately after Beijing, no, not at all. She has said that's it. But I think the lure of London was too great. I mean, for any athlete to do a London Games, it is amazing. And the crowds are just phenomenal, you know.
And what have you been going through in the last week, Jerry?
Well, we've actually had a great time. I've been laying a patio at my son's as payment for staying with him and taking our mind off it. So we've had a great time. A lot of support, a lot of media stuff. And that's just helped us sort of concentrate on other things.
Indeed. And there's the most majestic story about the tickets. Just tell us about your mum, Jerry.
Night that the tickets were closing, my mother, who's 85, applied for some tickets. She came up with two bars finals tickets. Absolutely fantastic, because we obviously were delighted to get those. And I hope she's watching, Mum.
Indeed. Well, I'm sure she is. Yes, give her a little wave straight down there. But you'll be off to your seats, and incredibly, you've got two seats, and that are right in front of the asymmetric bars.
Yeah, right in front of the bars. But I don't know whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, really. But I'll be doing the bar routine with her as usual.
Indeed. So you will be able to watch then, even if it will be through split fingers.
Yes. No, I do watch, but I pity the poor person sitting next to me, because I'll be doing the bars with her.
That'll be me.
Well, listen, you summed it up beautifully when you said you just hope that she can leave this arena having done what she set out to do, and if a medal is attached, then so be it.
Yeah, she just wants to do a clean routine, do the routine of her life, and whether she gets a medal or not, she'll go away proud, and we'll go away very proud parents.
Well, it goes without saying, you'll be incredibly proud anyway because of what your daughter has done.
Yeah, she's done so much. I think this would be the icing on the cake, but she'll be remembered, I hope, for the athlete she's been.
She will be indeed. And that's it. Jerry, there's still a little bit more time to do a bit of hands behind the back pacing before it's time. So we'll let you go. Thank you so much, honestly. A final word for everybody watching this at home.
Sorry,
just a final word. I mean, everybody's going to be on the edge of their seat as well, but you are too. It's lovely to see you both. Okay, we'll let you go. And we will concentrate now on at the men's rings final, because if you just look behind me, the gymnasts are being introduced. Yes, we're just hoping that everything goes her way. I mean, so much can happen in so little time, and you just want it to flow as beautifully as possible. Now, we can all stand here at Jenny and talk about how inspiring Beth Tweddle is, but you are living proof of that, aren't you?
Well, yeah, obviously I always looked up to her when I was a younger gymnast. I mean, what little girl didn't? She's the best we've ever had in Britain, and now I've been training with her at the City of Liverpool for 5 years, and I've made it to the Olympic Games too, so she really is a great inspiration.
And she did make you feel like it was possible to compete with the best gymnasts.
Of course, yeah. I mean, she's proved that Britain, can win medals and can win gold medals.
Yeah, well, it's not going to be easy. She's going to have to win that medal here. It's not a matter of just walking out here and getting through the routine. She's got to pack it with difficulty, because there are some incredible gymnasts in this final, not least Pei Keck-Sin, Victoria Komova, and a certain Miss Gabby Douglas, who was sparkling in the all-around final.